Hey everyone, welcome back to another video by AppSec Engineers. This video is part of a two-part series where we're going to showcase one of our labs from a new course that we are planning to launch called DevSecOps with Jenkins, which is part of our DevSecOps learning path on AppSec Engineers. In our last video, we created three separate jobs on Jenkins and essentially stitched them together to form a pipeline. The first Jenkins job was configured to run a source composition analysis scan against the dependencies of our Python application. The second job was configured to run a static application security test against the source code of our Python application. And finally, the last job was configured to run a dynamic application security test against a running instance of our Python application. So in this video, we're actually going to run the entire pipeline and also observe the results that have been generated. Let's get started. If this is the sort of content you'd like and enjoy, please consider subscribing to this YouTube channel and also like the video. We're also active on LinkedIn and Twitter, where we're going to be constantly posting updates around Kubernetes security, cloud security, AppSec, DevSecOps, and a whole lot more. So the way this is currently configured is, first, as soon as I trigger my source composition analysis, it's going to run the SAA scan first, and then it's going to trigger my SAST scan, and finally it's going to trigger my DAST scan as well. So in this example, I'm going to trigger it manually, but obviously you can have a Git hook of some sort which says for every commit to the master branch or to the staging branch, it should automatically go ahead and trigger this particular job. I'm going to go ahead and click on build now, and it should start running all of these scans. So as you can see, the SAST scan is currently running. So I'm just going to hit refresh. So the SAA scan was completed in less than 15 seconds, and the SAST scan is complete as well. And we finally have our DAST scan, which is our OWASP ZAP scan, currently running. So while this is happening, let's quickly head over to each of these jobs and look at the reports that have been generated. So first, let's look at the source composition analysis. And we ran the scan using a tool called PyRadar. So it's going to tell us that this was executed 38 seconds ago. So let's look at the SAA report. And we can see that it was able to find a few high severity flaws as well. So it was able to find an issue in the PyYAML library and the URL lib3 library. And it was able to find a few other medium severity and low severity flaws as well. Additionally, this tool is also going to give you the CWE ID of every issue that it finds, which can be extremely helpful. So once this is done, we can head over to Python SAST and look at the results generated there as well. Similarly, it's going to tell us this result was generated approximately 1 minute ago. Let's quickly have a look at the bandit report that has been generated. So this is going to find quite a few flaws. So it's going to tell us that there was a hard-coded password string. Then it's also going to tell us that we are using an insecure MD2 or MD5 hash functions. It's going to show us the severity. It's also going to give us the confidence. And finally, it's also going to show us the vulnerable code snippet. So it's going to tell us that in the file app.py, this piece of code is currently vulnerable. So this is going to be our SAST result. And finally, I'm assuming our DAST scan is complete as well. So it's going to tell us that the DAST scan was completed approximately 2 minutes ago. So we can head over to the OWASP ZAP report and look at the result that was generated as well. So if you remember, this was simply a spider scan, not an active scan or an authenticated scan. So with a simple spider scan, it was able to find a medium level flaw, which was the X-frame options header not set. And it was also able to find two low severity flaws as well. This is the ZAP scan result that was generated. So if you want to learn how to create DevSecOps pipelines, which are more complex, and if you want to integrate things like authenticated ZAP scans, and if you want to create a complete pipeline using something like Jenkins files, head over to appsecengineer.com to learn more. If you found this video useful, please consider subscribing to the channel and like the video. And don't forget to follow us on LinkedIn and Twitter for this sort of content and updates. If you are looking to learn more about cloud-native security, Kubernetes security, DevSecOps, AppSec automation, threat modeling, and a whole lot more. Go get a subscription for amazing courses and a ton of hands-on labs on AppSecEngineer.com.